Yeah. Come on. On that sunny
day. Hey guys, Dr. Josh Jagoda here. Welcome back for this week's episode, and today we are going to finish off with the last aspect of nerve flossing for the upper extremity, and that will be the radial nerve. So the radial nerve will come down into the lateral forearm and then innervate some of the digits on the dorsal aspect or the back of hand aspect of the hand here. So patients will come in, they may feel some numbness and tingling going down into the back end of these fingers here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to learn how to floss it. To recap real quick, flossing is a way of taking that nerve back and forth through a course through its anatomy. So this way the nerve can glide and slide evenly through its structures. So in order to, again, tension it at the neck, what we're going to do is look away. And then to provide slack into the neck, we're going to look towards. So again, we're going to look away for some tension and then slack. In order to really get the radial nerve, what I really like to do is I like to take patient's arm and they'll kind of internally rotate. So you'll go like this. And then at the same time, you're going to bend. So just like you're doing a forearm stretch, but like the top aspect of the forearm, you'll curl the fist and then you'll rotate inward. The further you go backwards, the more you will get that tension. To add a little extra tension, a lot of patients will actually find that they have tension just doing this. But what you may want to do is take your thumb. So a lot of people, in order to make a fist or like a punching fist, they'll curl their fingers and then wrap the thumb on the outside. This time, what you're going to do is you're going to take your finger or your thumb and you're going to wrap it on the inside. So you'll grab the thumb, wrap the first 2, 3, 4 fingers around, and then you'll come down and away, just like that. And so what you'll do as you come and down and do this, you're going to look towards or provide slack here while you're tensioning down here. And then what you're going to do is you're going to uncurl your fingers, uncurl your wrist, and curl the elbow. So again, you'll curl everything here while extending the wrist so that you can really tension that nerve going downward or inferiorly while putting some slack up into the nerve bundles up here. Then what you'll do is you'll tension away, which will tension the neck portion, but you'll relax this. So it'll look like this. Start here, come down, extend if you need to, or just stay where you're at. You're providing slack here. And this is what the radial nerve flossing will be. So go ahead, give that one a try. You can try that anywhere between 5 and 10 times initially, and then you want to progress from 10 to 15 times, pretty much a couple times a day to really get that nerve to glide and slide throughout the day. So give that a try. Really good and really effective for those of you who are having numbness or tingling on the lateral aspect of the forearm or in the lateral or 3 digits here, specifically more on the back side. So I'm Dr. Josh Jagoda. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you next time. Take care.